हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ सागर रमेश कुट्टे, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, जेएमडी कॉलेज, सिन्नर, नासिक। टुडे वी हैव गोइंग टू डिस्कस एमएससी सेकंड सेमिस्टर 3, दैट इज कोर्स ऑफ लेजर। इन दिस कोर्स लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस आइंस्टाइन कोएफिशिएंट एंड आइंस्टाइन रिलेशन। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस कंडीशन फॉर लार्ज स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन। लेजिंग इज द प्रोसेस विच लीड द इमिशन ऑफ स्टिमुलेटेड फोटोज ड्यू टू द ट्रांजिशन ऑफ एटम फ्रॉम मेटास्टेबल स्टेट टू द ग्राउंड स्टेट आफ्टर अचीविंग पॉपुलेशन इन्वर्जन फॉर द जनरेशन ऑफ लेजर। स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन इज इसेंशियल। Stimulated emission has to be induced or stimulated and is generated under the special condition as started by Einstein when the population inversion exists between upper and lower level among the atomic system. It is possible to realize amplified stimulated emission and the stimulated emission has same frequency and has incident radiation. The absorption and spontaneous emission always occur together with stimulated emission. As we know that Einstein coefficient relation is A21 upon B12 is equal to 8 pi h mu cube upon c cube. This will be the equation number first. Therefore, the ratio of stimulated transition to the spontaneous transition is R is equal to stimulated transition upon spontaneous transition. Now stimulated emission and spontaneous emission we'll discuss last lecture. Now spontaneous transition means an atom is upper level can decay spontaneously to the lower level and emit the photon of frequency h mu. If the transition between E2 and E1 is relative, this photon has a random direction of phase. Stimulated emission and incident photon causes an upper level atom to decay, emitting stimulated photon whose property are identical to those of incident photon. The term stimulated underlines the fact that this kind of radiation occur only if an incident photon is present. The amplification arises due to the similarities between the incident and emitted photon. Now R is equal to dN1 upon dt stimulated upon dN1 upon dt spontaneous is equal to B21 N2 rho mu upon A21 N2. Now R is equal to B21 upon A21 rho mu. This will be the equation number 2. But we know that rho mu is equal to 8 pi h mu cube upon c cube upon e raised to E2 minus E1 upon kt minus 1. This is equation and proof in last lecture. Therefore, equation 2 become R is equal to B21 upon A21 8 pi h mu cube upon c cube upon e raised to E2 minus E1 upon kt minus 1. From equation 2, R is equal to 1 upon 8 pi h mu cube upon c cube into 8 pi h mu cube upon c cube upon e raised to minus E2 minus 1 E1 upon kt minus 1. Now R is equal to 1 upon e raised to E2 minus E1 upon kt minus 1. This will be the equation number first. In equation 3 gives the ratio of stimulated transition to the spontaneous transition if both are equal. At thermodynamic equilibrium, B12 is equal to B21, then R is equal to N2 upon N1. This will be the equation number 4, and N2 upon N1 is very 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 less than 1. The two equation 3 and 4 are to be satisfied to make stimulated emission overhang the spontaneous emission. To the sum of 3 conditions are to be satisfied to make stimulated transition overwhelm the other transition. First condition will be the population at excited level should be greater than that the lower energy level. Second condition will be the ratio B12 upon A21 should be large. And third condition will be a very high density of radiation density should be present in the medium. A medium amplifies light when these three conditions are fulfilled. Now this will be the derivation of condition for large stimulated emission. Thank you so much.